Hello. Good evening to everyone. Welcome to my channel. Okay, I have another one herbal remedies to share with you. To all of you, please like, subscribe, and leave a comment. Okay. Bago nga palang lahat, nagpapasalamat nga pala ako dun sa pamilya ng ginamot ko kanina sa Caloocan North. Pumayag sila na kuhaan ko sila ng video. So, yun, nakapag-upload ako ng ginawa ko kanina. Gumawa ako ng spiritual healing process at saka Filipino Healot Wellness. Isang buong pamilya, 7 katao ang ginamot ko doon. 7 sila na tinawas ko, pero 4 lang yung hinilot ko. So, okay. Thank you sa pamilya ng pinuntahan ko kanina. Okay, nakikita nyo ba to? Ito yung Moringa Pupilia Tree of Life. Yan yung miraculosa herbal. The Oleifera Moringa is a tree of life of the family of Moringaceae. It is native of India, but today it grows on all continents and big to be useful. There are 13 specific of Moringa that have almost the same nutritional and medicinal properties. Nothing of this shrub is useless. The Lord wanted it, so Mother Nature has everything planned for our well-being. Where you are, plants a species of this shrub that will not ask you nothing to post, and then to prove to you that he is treating more than 40 common diseases. Let's learn the simple things of life instead of suffering all the time and running at great expense behind drugs, dietary supplements, vitamins, and antibiotics, fortifier, and whatever. I do not say that these things are useless. They are useful and very useful, but we abuse them to the point of intoxication. Even the great Hippocrates, father of the medicines moderni, well complain about it. If it was again on our land, all that the living being needs to be live, heal, and be well is in this plant. Indeed, this shrub, because of the nutritive and medicinal values in a complete food, a living food, and a drug for more than 40 common diseases. The fresh leaves, pods, and dry leaf powder of Moringa oleifera contain carbohydrates, lipids, protein, all essential amino acids, almost all vitamin A, B, B1, B2, B3, C, and E, and etc., mineral, salt, metals, and metalloids, iron, zinc, copper, sulfur, manganese, fibers, trace elements, and many active ingredients. Bark and roots also contains many active ingredients that work effectively against several diseases. Fortunately, the leaves that used to be consumed by sheep and a small minority of the population in Black Africa are now being taken over and much sought after in many black African countries because it is health value. Chemical composition and properties. Research has been conducted in many countries by leading researchers, and they have all confirmed that many uses that our parents made of leaves, seeds, bark, and roots of moringa for centuries, time immemorial. To be honest, the African pharmacopoeia does not deceive or lie because it is based on ancestral practices handed down from generation to generation. They are some scientifically proven practice. All vegetative parts, leaves, seeds, bark, and roots contains a sharp glycoside which hydrolyzes at 100 degrees C in the presence of water. The foliar has a very interesting contain of protein comparable to 90%, 8 of 9% of the wet weight, above 25% of the dry weight, in vitamin A, almost 2,000 micrograms of 100 grams, in vitamin C, 100 milligrams per 100 grams, vitamin B1, 220 micrograms per 100 grams, calcium, iron, and potassium. A study done in Thailand in 2007 shows that moringa contains antioxidant substances that further lower blood lipid levels. A Japanese study of 2007 shows that the consumption of moringa leaves improves the diabetes of naturally diabetic rats. The active compound seems to be very ubiquitous and common polyphenols in plants, derivatives of quercetol, camphorol, rutin, and certain phenolic acids, chorogenic acid. Leaf essential oil and hydro alcoholic extract 70% ethanol. Seeds are active on common dermatophytes. A 2005 Chinese study confirmed that antifungal potential of certain moringa extract on certain parasitic fungi on the skin. Trichophyton rubrum, Trichophyton minta glophyte, Ephedrophyton zoxanthum, and Microsporum canis is almost not antifungal. The seed contains 15-35% of the light yellow, odorless and sweet edible oil that has the particularity of being to rancid and very fluid. As for the cakes obtained after extraction of the oil, they are rich in protein and can make it possible to cause the localization of the impurities contained in the troubled water and thus to purify it. Finally, the traditional antibacterial uses of bark and especially roots can be explained by the presence of three antibiotic substances, pyrigosfermin, ang tumin and spirochine whose antibacterial spectra are very, very wide and spirochine is cardiotonic. Some uses: fatigue, intellectual fatigue, diabetes, hypertension, hepatitis B. Product: Moringa leaves, olivera, euvoxatin in gown and minam, cafatima in phone. Preparation: dry the fresh leaves in the shade and reduce them to a fine powder, then put in a pot. Direction: put a tablespoon of 15 milligram 10 ml of the powder in a liter and a half of warm water. 15 minutes later, consume the mixture thus obtained during the day. Repeat the operation for 7 days. Anemia, memory disorder, asthenia, rheumatism, prostatitis, bronchitis, excess cholesterol. Turn dry moringa leaves into powder and take a teaspoonful 3 times a day. In the middle of the meal, powder is a powerful dietary supplement, I will say a superfood. Aid memory for parents, students, and students. In the mornings, make a homogeneous mixture of a tablespoon of the powder, a tablespoon of honey, and lemon juice, then drink or lapi. In sinusitis, in the evening, at bedtime, boil a handful of oleander leaves and inhale the vapors with a well-covered head. Do not drink as toxic. Okay? Yan yung moringa. Kung tawagin dito sa atin, sa Pilipinas, ay malunggay. Sa English ay moringa. The tree of life. Yan lamang po ang may babahagi ko sa ngayon. Sa mga susunod na araw ay marami pa akong ibabahagi na mga herbal remedies. Napakasimple lang at napaka mabisa. Mga miraculous plants yan, binabahagi kong yan. Yan ay subok ko na sa aking mga pasyente. So kahit ako, yan din po yung iniinom ko. So hindi na ako nagpapadoktor o ano, kasi ako mismo gumagamot ng sarili ko. Kasi herbalist din po ako. So alam ko yung mga herbal na dapat ikagagaling ng para sa pamilya ko, para sa mga apo ko, at para din sa mga pasyente ko. Thanks for watching. Hope you like it. And please don't forget to subscribe and ring the icon bell so that in my next video you can subscribe and watch and update my YouTube channel. Okay, thank you and God bless. Bye bye sa inyong lahat. Good evening again.